Hello student, today I'm teaching you English for class 5th and our today's topic is subject verb agreement. Okay, so this is your 9th chapter of your grammar book. When we write a sentence, okay, it is very important for the subject to agree with the verb. Okay, so while we are making a sentence or while we are writing the sentence, it is very important that the subject should be agree with the verb. So subject means by whom we are talking. Okay, maybe she is girl or any man or any of the thing. Okay, agree with the verb. Verb means the work which he or she or it is doing. So let us understand what this means and how this is done. So in a sentence, if the subject is singular, the verb too must be singular. So this is the first rule, that in a sentence, when the subject is singular, like if we are talking about a girl, so she is singular, the verb whatever she is doing, that also be singular. Okay, for example, Mona drinks juice in the evening. So Mona is a girl, drinks, she, the verbs working, that is also singular. So this is the first example. Then next, the cobbler mends our shoes. So cobbler is subject and mends is a verb. Rahul is an architect. So Rahul is subject and is the auxiliary, or we can say helping verb is, which also indicating about Rahul, and this is a singular verb. Next, Reena has bought a new house. So Reena, again singular, has indicates the verb, that is also singular. Next, the child cries loudly in the hall. So child, we are talking about a single child, this is a singular, and cries also indicates that the child is cries. Okay, now next important thing, in a sentence, if the subject is plural, the verb too must be plural. Okay, if the subject is plural and the verb must be plural, so in that condition your verb also be very much must be plural. For example, the children, when we are talking about the children, so children's are plural, are is helping verb, is auxiliary. Okay, this is also plural. So the children are playing in the park. Next, Rose and Winnie have reached early. So have is also a helping verb. This is a plural helping verb, and Rose and Winnie are the two. That means they are the plural subjects. Here the subjects are plural. Next, the singers sing melodiously. So singers, the singers, we are talking about those singers who sings very much melodiously, and sing is also sing. This is also a plural form. Singers, plural form, and sings also by their song. Okay, by all the singers who are singing, who sings melodiously. So both the cases we found plural. The subject also singular, and the plural also singular. Now in a sentence, if the subject is you, the verb will always be plural. For example, you are a nice girl. So when we use subject you, so we must use plural. Okay, verb we must use plural. For example, you are a nice girl, so you is a subject and are is a helping verb, and it indicates plural. Okay, so You are a nice girl. Next, when the subject is you, you have. Have is one of the auxiliary, or we can say verb, okay, and it is a plural form. Okay, then you dance gracefully. So dance is verb. Okay, then you know how to cook better. Now when the subject agrees with the verb, it is called subject verb agreement. Now in this chapter we are starting subject verb agreement. So subject, I told you that whom we are talking, any person's name, any child name, or he or she. Okay, verb is any task, whatever they all are doing. Okay, so when the combination of subject and verb in an accurate way, that is called the subject verb agreement. So am is are, was and were are forms of the verb be. Okay, then has and have are form of the verb have. Do and does are form of the verb do. Now in table, this is given in your page number 63 of your grammar book. Singular verbs are sets, plural it will convert sit, stitches stitch, sings sing, cries is cry, flies fly, leaves leave, is are, was were, has have, does do. Okay, now I'll explain with the help of example also. So let me take two examples of am, is, are and two examples of has and have. Okay, so first I'll take the example of am, is and are. So first sentence is I dash participating in a singing competition. So what we will write? I always followed by am. So we will write I am. Second, you dash most welcome. So you always followed by are. You are most welcome. Okay. Next, fill in the blanks with has and have. So my parents have a desire to go to Dubai. Because parents, so we will use have. And next, she dash her own drawing kit. So she is a singular, it's followed by has. So she has her own drawing kit. So thank you and have a nice day.